From Tampa Bay's streaming news source, brought to you by AlertTodayFlorida.com. This is ABC Action News.
You want to watch out for some fog this morning on your commute. Your full weather forecast is coming up in just a few minutes. Good morning, I'm James Tully, and here are your ABC Action News headlines. Tampa police shoot and kill a man after they say he shot at them several times in the middle of a busy neighborhood. The police chief says the man was wanted for murder out of Georgia. Officers spotted his vehicle on I-275 Sunday, tried to pull him over, and that's when they say he started firing his gun and led officers to an East Tampa neighborhood. He tried to carjack an innocent bystander, and that is when officers fired the fatal shots. People working and living in downtown Tampa need to be ready for a road closure all this week that could cause some big delays and backups. FDOT is closing the westbound lanes of Kennedy Boulevard near Ashley Drive, the Hyde Park Avenue, and the Hillsborough River. They're creating a two-lane bike lane and replacing drainage pipes. A defunct Chinese space lab did crash into the South Pacific. The Chinese space station says that most parts were burned up in the reentry process. The 40-foot-long Heavenly Palace launched in September 2011. It was a prototype for China's ultimate goal of a permanent space station that's expected to launch around 2022. The Chinese government told the UN in May 2017 that its space lab had ceased functioning the year before. Today is the last day you can pay your property taxes in Pinellas County without getting a fine. They were technically due Saturday, but the deadline was extended to a weekday. You can't pay this by mail at this point, but you can still pay online today. If your payment is late, the county will charge you at least 1.5% interest on unpaid taxes. And you can get a free lunch today at Little Caesars, thanks to the University of Maryland, Baltimore County. The pizza chain promised everyone lunch if a number 16 seed beat a number 1 seed in the tournament. That, of course, happened for the first time this year when UMBC beat UVA. So today you can get a free $5 lunchbox. Just go to a participating Little Caesars between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. Maybe you'll see Jason Adams there when he's done giving you your forecast.
I mean, when you're talking about free lunch, why not? Hey, we've got great weather in store for us again today. But like James said, watch out for a little bit of patchy fog for the morning commute. It'll quickly fade away by 10, 11 o'clock, and then we'll break out into mostly sunny skies by the noon hour. And at that point, temperatures are already back into the upper 70s to near 80. I am expecting to see a couple of showers popping up, especially after 2 p.m. as the sea breeze propagates inland from the beaches, and that could kick off some storms even as we go into tonight's forecast, especially for those of you well east of I-75 through Polk County down towards Highlands County at that point. Temperatures will fall back into the 70s once the sea breeze front passes, and then we basically are going to repeat this forecast as we go into the next couple of days with temperatures staying into the middle 80s and a slight chance for a few thunderstorms. James?
All right, Jason, quick reminder, you can get all of your news updates all day long on your favorite streaming device, and don't forget to download the free ABC Action News app. Have a great morning.
Don't they know they're supposed to use the crosswalk?
Hey, you on your phone. Put that down until you cross the street.
Whoa, stop! Can't you see there are pedestrians crossing here?
I can't take it anymore!
Drivers, put your phone down. Be alert. Watch for pedestrians, especially when approaching a crosswalk. Pedestrians, always use the crosswalk. And push the button so I can help you cross safely. Alert today, alive tomorrow, because safety doesn't happen by accident.